and their guest was going to be Kurt Angle, which I found odd because Kurt Angle's the GM, and why is he going to be a guest on his own show? But he came out there, and I love that Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn had the little lawn chair for their guest, which is hilarious. And what's even funnier is that Kurt Angle sits in it. Of course he does, because Kurt Angle's goofy and he's hilarious, and why would he not sit in it? So as Sami and Kevin are insulting Kurt Angle and making fun of him, he reminds them that he's in the Royal Rumble, along with Shane McMahon and a lot of other people that would like to get their hands on Sami and Kevin, and then goes on to make a tag team match for later on in the night on Raw, pitting Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens against Braun Strowman and Bobby Lashley. So yeah, they're fucked. We fast forward to that match. The star of the match, of course, is Braun Strowman. The love of my life, my reason for living. He's out there being hilarious. The best was when he was running. He was sprinting, doing laps around the ring, and just running over Kevin Owens. Gave him two really vicious shoulder tackles, and then even gave him a running dropkick. So every time Kevin Owens would get up, he would be completely run down again by Braun Strowman. Strowman would eventually get his hands on Sami Zayn, nail him with the power slam, and pin him right in the middle of the ring. And Strowman and Lashley stood tall. That's a pretty unstoppable team. I kind of laughed at that team because I was thinking back at WrestleMania when a lot of fans were predicting and insisting, good mic work, it's totally obvious that Bobby Lashley is going to be his tag team partner. And I'm like, I don't think it's that obvious. Why would they even put the two of them together? I thought the team was kind of insane. But here they are as a team on Monday Night Raw. And like I said with Lashley earlier, you know, when I look at Lashley and I talked about him in my past couple of commentaries as he was coming into the company, I just don't view him as that Brock Lesnar level type of superstar. I just don't. I don't feel it with him. But the guy is amazing. He's very good. He looks like $1 million and he's got that MMA background. And I think for Lashley, if they're going to book him effectively, the only way you can really, truly, effectively book a guy like Bobby Lashley and make him a success is if you book him like a Brock Lesnar. So I don't know what their plans for him are down the road, if he's going to get title matches, if he's going to have a match with Brock or whatever, but I'm almost thinking that just a smiling babyface doesn't work for him. He doesn't connect. He doesn't even get much of a reaction. So with Bobby Lashley, I say turn this guy heel, book him and present him like Brock Lesnar, give him a big victory, and make the fans actually believe that this guy's an ass-kicking monster. And who knows, maybe in a few months you can actually build this guy up to where fans will be very interested to potentially see him contend for the title. And depending on what happens between Brock and Roman at the Royal Rumble and later on this summer and how long Brock keeps the belt, maybe you can set up Lashley versus Brock at SummerSlam. If Brock is leaving, you know, you want to put somebody else over other than Roman Reigns. So giving Brock a loss to either Braun Strowman or Lashley, I think would be a good idea. But as far as Lashley goes, I think the only way this guy is going to mean anything is if he is presented similar to Brock Lesnar. So I hope that Bobby Lashley's return to the company is not a waste. So we'll have to wait and see where that goes.